What we have here today is a sweet demonstration of the sampling distribution of the mean, otherwise known as the distribution of sample means. We've laid out 48 plates, each with a bag of M&Ms on it. We're going to dump out these M&Ms, there's Dr. Rogers doing so, across all 48 plates. This is a very tedious process, so we've sped things up a little bit to make it go faster. Once we have all of the M&Ms dumped out, we're going to separate them by color. We are interested in the blue M&Ms. Of course, you could pick any color if you wanted. You could use orange or green or yellow, but we've chosen blue. Once we've separated out the blue M&Ms, we're going to count them. There I am helping along. Dr. Rogers got tired of me sitting over the corner just watching him, so he recruited my help. Once we have the blue M&Ms sorted, we're going to be interested in the average number of blue M&Ms per bag, or per plate in this case. And what we're going to do then is take random samples of n equals 5 and compute an average. Once we've done that, we're going to do that 50 times, taking 50 random samples, each with n equals 5 plates. Then we're going to construct a histogram. That histogram will be the distribution of sample means. Remember that the central limit theorem says that the distribution of sample means will be approximately normal and will have an expected value of the mean equal to the population mean. Now, the true population mean we've computed by taking all blue M&Ms across all plates and dividing by 48, the number of plates. Remember, the central limit theorem also says that the standard deviation of the distribution of sample means is equal to sigma, the population standard deviation, divided by the square root of the sample size. Let's see how the data turned out.